How do you move from here to here? What about this one? Or this? Or that one? Or even here? This one? Or here? Or that one? What about this? This is the story of Bida University Achina Onneh, a child of the Catholic Diocese of Awka. Listen to the proprietor of the university.
In the first place, I thank God that you are talking about this university. And I would like to go back a little bit to the genesis of what you are talking about. And I would like to start with myself, what I believe, and as a priest, as a bishop, as a pastor, the need for what we call Catholic education, the effects it can have on an individual, as against other forms of education we have around. And when I'm speaking, I mean my own self. I have started. I had my primary school in St. Anthony's College School, Nanka. Did my secondary school at All Hallows Seminary of Nature. Did my philosophy at St. Joseph's Major Seminary, Ekore, and my theology at St. Bigger Memorial Seminary in Enugu. And I did my specialization course in moral theology in University of the Holy Cross, Rome. All this I went through kind of mission arrangement, college school, and I could see the effect. And so when eventually after 40 years, the government of Anambra State under Mr. Peter, we decided to return our schools to us. It was really a welcome development, and they gave the church another opportunity to do things the way they consider best for the good of our people. Nursery schools, primary schools, secondary schools that are really college schools. I consider it necessary that the next school should come, which is the university, because after preparing these children in nursery school, primary school, secondary school, somebody said after UK, what next? And so in order to have continuity, we decided to go into this project of a college university for cadets.
As you can see, work is ongoing at the site.
The site now, we are seeing the physical structures going on. We are at the site of the university chapel. Then over there, you see the Faculty of Natural Sciences being set up. And beside it, the central administrative building.
Many hands are at work in support of the university. The former governor of Anambra State, Sir Peter Obi.
Well, I'll say, if there's anything the diocese has done in its existence, this is the most important, the most critical, in terms of their commitment to human development. For the people, this is the only thing they can bequeath. This is the only life they have. To educate the society is to make the society work.
And the governor of Anambra State, Chief Willie Obiano.
I'm supporting Peter University, like other universities, because we have very few tertiary institutions in the Southeast as a whole. And in Anambra in particular, we have only six institutions, you know, two federal, five on the whole actually, you know. And we need more investors.
And those who plan, coordinate, execute, and support the project in various ways. Among them is the Auxiliary Bishop of Awka, Most Reverend Jonas Benson Okoye.
At my appointment as the coordinator, for the first time I realized that the university project was not an easy one. But I must really thank God for the gift of our diocesan bishop, and the good people of our diocese, our priests, and the lay faithful. A lot has been done, and as I'm speaking to you currently, we already have the water borehole functioning, two water boreholes functioning with the capacity of 15,000 overhead tanks. And then one of the major, what is going to be the largest faculty, that is of natural science, is ongoing now. And we are coming out from the foundation level. We have also started on the project on the central administrative club. And one of our good people accepted to do the chapel his concern was to donate the chapel for the school, for the university, and that has also come up.
Mothers are interested in the welfare of their children, the educational aspect, spiritual aspect, all aspects are mothers' concern. So, as a result of this, when they heard about the when they heard about Peter University, they were quite interested. So, as a result of that, we should pick a hostel and build in order to join the bishop to erect that university. As a result of that, we had to chart how to go into it, and we started with 500 naira.
It's a matter of joy and happiness that the diocese has gathered the enormous courage required and the possible financial resources available to try to start a Catholic university in the diocese. A Catholic university in Awka diocese would be a very progressive contribution to knowledge. A Catholic education is a popular venture. Many of us, I can say somebody like myself, went through the Catholic education and it had a lot of impact on my progress, the humble progress I made in life.
One thing I can say is that the support to Peter's University is a support that will be well used, a support that will be well utilized, a support that will definitely help to continue to mold the students and our children. What we are training students for is both in character and in learning. And I think the church is poised to actually continue to deliver on that. So the partnership that we have with the mission is really, really working.
Now, the support of our people for this dream, our dream university, it cannot be overemphasized. In fact, their ownership of this project is extremely important because we cannot do it without our people. We cannot do it without the faithful of Awka Diocese. What we need to do, what we want to do, is to build a model university where people can come and have all-round education, in the sense that they are not just getting certificates. They are going to have skills. They acquire skills. And that is our point of emphasis, acquire all-round skills. Skills for different kinds of jobs, as may someone's
because the higher institutions are now coming into our various homes.
So, we started on. University idea project is not a very simple story. It's extremely intensive financially, so the same.
One thing about our people is that they are very well known in the Catholic faith for their generosity. And this generosity transcends the various places where we find them. So we are very proud of our people, and we're also proud of our friends who have, in many cases, when we have talked to them, who have helped us in various ways with respect to the growth of the church.
First of all, we are grateful to the diocese, and we owe gratitude to God for making it possible this time. The best way for a rural community like Achina will develop, of course, is through this kind of university.
I encourage the government of Nigeria. I call on government of Anambra State, the host state, to come in and do something about it, offer support in the area of especially good road network and infrastructure and other facilities.
Right, just for now, we're trying to put up a fundraising event as to the reason that university has to be built.
Well, in the first place, I want to congratulate the diocese for thinking of having a university of their own, because in the first place, it's going to increase access. Access means availability of spaces to study in the higher institution. Give people opportunities to study in the university. So hostels are very, very, very important. Private persons may be invited to build hostels, either as endowments or even to partner on due own entrance.
Yes, I said something about endowment. That is people coming in to bring money, to bring the resources that may be required in running the institution. Then, apart from people who have come in to bring the resources, an aspect the university has to do is to name buildings, classrooms, halls against some very important persons. That is one way the university will make more friends, and those friends eventually will come together as stakeholders to develop the university.
And all these efforts are for who? For the future of our children and our communities.
By studying in a Catholic institution like Peter's University, Achina, I hope to gain good moral up.
Honestly, I'll gain a great discipline in studying in Catholic University. I'll gain a discipline that is beyond every human expectation. Because normally in a Catholic school, they have the great zeal, they have the great potential of making the student best in all they partake in, especially in academical, moral and social.